And a lot of people, they come to Torreya State Park and they think the Gregory House, or they think of the trails or the campground, but we're much, much more than that. As you drive in, you're passing much of our lands. You know, those open fields of golden, you know, wiregrass and little longleaf pines coming up. That's all efforts that you're seeing that started back in the early 2000s.
Right now, in a section of the park that isn't currently open to the public, the Florida Park Service and its partners are restoring 4,600 acres of sandhill habitat. They've already planted 1.6 million native longleaf pine trees. With this, they are returning the land to a biodiverse, fire-dependent ecosystem.
Doesn't look like much, but this is what's necessary to restore the site from a sand pine plantation back to a sandhill. 20 years ago, when the state purchased the Sweetwater property for Torreya State Park, the Sweetwater tract is about 6,000 acres, and of that we purchased 4,600 acres, which was in industrial pine plantation, and this is sand pine, which is native to Florida, but does not naturally occur in a sandhill habitat. Establishment of this plantation eliminated most of the native ground cover. You'll see that there isn't any wiregrass to speak of.
For contrast, here's the ground cover of an established, frequently burned longleaf habitat. Even with many of the plants dormant for the winter, you can see the diversity of the ecosystem.
Characterized by some large longleaf pine, wiregrass, and other attractive ground cover species, and lower density of hardwoods. It's actually really a prairie habitat. It's not a forest, you know, because you got so much sunlight on the ground that all these ground cover species are maintained and are gradually lost with the loss of fire. If they're not burned, they gradually become dominated by hardwoods, and you lose the longleaf pine, you also lose the ground cover species, which are essential to maintain things like gopher tortoises, for example.
That openness is important to other animals as well. To get from this to this, you need to start over from scratch.
We're planting some wiregrass seed out here.
Gotcha. How much more of this do you have to do?
Ooh. A lot.
A lot more. We just started.
Yeah, we got, I'm driving in, I'm sure y'all saw it, and we got, I think, 400 acres or so acres we're trying to plant.
About 300.
About 300 acres. I don't think we've got 10 yet planted, so.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Cool.
Slow and steady's the only way to do it.
You might wonder why they start by planting wiregrass instead of trees.
Trying to get this in our eyes.
The ground cover, that's the hardest part to restore to any system here in the longleaf pine range. That is the key function of the system that really promotes fire. That's where the majority of the diversity is. It's the habitat that all the species use to really make the system what it is. When we think of the iconic longleaf pine, a wiregrass system. It's the ground cover that's really the bread and butter of it.
Before they plant, they need to harvest seed. And for wiregrass to seed, it needs fire.
This is Torreya Sweetwater Tract, what we call Restoration Zone 7. This zone was just burned a few months ago in July. You can see how the wiregrass has flowered and produced seed. And a prescribed fire is actually essential to cause the wiregrass to produce seed. Wiregrass depends on prescribed fire, and so without that, it can become senescent and then gradually dominated by invasive hardwood species. The pruning effect that the fire had on these laurel oaks, prior to the fire it was this high, and now the fire has knocked it back down to the base.
There are hundreds of understory plant species found in the sandhill habitat. They can't plant them all, but wiregrass is a good start.
We kind of restore the foundation, and then over time, fire and then just the natural processes in the system kind of starts to bring back the remaining diversity. Once we sort of build the house, it takes hundreds, if not thousands of years to really see what a lot of people call pre-Columbian conditions.
Well, I would say within 40 or 50 years, it's going to start looking pretty natural. The longleaf will get taller, but it's going to take 100 years or more before it, you know, looks like it did with the mature longleaf. Hopefully our grandchildren will appreciate it.
Yeah. For WFSU, I'm Rob Diaz de Villegas. For more stories on fire ecology, longleaf ecosystems, and the Apalachicola Bluffs and Ravines region, visit the WFSU Ecology blog. And if you like what you see, subscribe.